Hello and welcome everyone on here with part 65 of the Saxon Let's Play for Total War Attila. You will notice one or two things different about this video. First of all, there will be the option for 1080 60fps and 720 60fps. I'm actually trying out using OBS, which is the same program I use to live stream with, to record 60fps, because it has the option to record with the same NVIDIA NVEC codec.
I bring word.
Oh, hello.
That my lord looks to end.
Yes, sure thing. Perfect. You're not going to harass my coast anymore, and I can just rebuild that settlement. Great. It's using the same codec that NVIDIA ShadowPlay uses. Now, the reason why I don't like using ShadowPlay is I found it crashes and it's not as reliable as I'd like it to be, and there's not as many configurable options as some other programs. But also, it doesn't allow me to split my audio separately into two different files, which means that basically if there's a problem with my commentary, it's like it's too loud, it's too quiet, I can boost it in editing easily. Now what I'm actually doing with OBS is against that. It's one file, the audio is all in one file, I can't easily edit it and tweak my vocals higher than the in-game sound, so I have to balance that all beforehand. So I would really appreciate your feedback if you could watch the whole video through. I don't know if we're going to get a battle this part. I will try and force a battle somewhere, because I kind of feel like I need to see how the battle sounds are balanced versus campaign map. I know campaign map's quite quiet anyway, and there's just kind of ambient sounds going on. But let me know, once you've watched the whole video, if possible, how the audio balances. Is my mic too loud? Is the in-game too quiet? Is there a specific of the in-game that's too quiet? Because as you can see, I'll show you quickly. Let's go through these. Do nothing. No, he can get the promotion. As you can see in the sound options, there are multiple options. So if you think the speech should be put a bit higher, the effects should be put a bit higher or lower, music higher or lower, and master will probably leave where it is. But let me know about all of those. That's where I've got it at the moment. Now, the reason I'm doing this in a Let's Play and not doing a separate video to test it is because, to be honest, probably more of you will actually watch the Let's Play part. And I always appreciate the feedback you guys give me on this. It shouldn't have too big an impact. I have already done some testing this morning myself to check it out, and it does seem to be working fine. Now, you'll also notice there is an FPS counter in the top left. I don't think there is. I'm looking over at the OBS overlay on my second monitor. It isn't showing up, I don't think, on the recording, so maybe that's because OBS isn't seeing the little Steam overlay. But I've got the Steam overlay FPS counter. Now, I'm not actually recording dead on 60fps because Attila isn't that well optimized. So it won't run at 60fps all the time, but it will run at slightly higher frame rate. So let me know if you notice overall slightly, you know, snazzier quality, nippier quality, and if you like it or not. You know, if I have problems with this, I'll go back to 30fps, but eventually I'm going to have to jump onto the 60fps bandwagon. The technology isn't there for me to do exactly what I do now with split audio channels just yet at 30fps. Straight up 60. So what I've decided to do is kind of go back to the older ways of recording everything in one file. I just have to balance it all before recording and hope for the best. And I did that for like 4 years, so there's nothing wrong with going back to that now. It's just I've kind of been spoiled a little bit by having the option of separate audio channels and recordings. But I'll give this a go. There are other ways that I could record separately with Audacity, but syncing up audio, I don't particularly like doing that, because it sometimes I get desyncs and things like that, and I'd much rather either all in one file or a dedicated program that does the video and audio all separately and everything. But yeah, anyway, I won't bore you guys with any more details, but just thought I'd let you know. If you're watching this in 1080p 60fps, let me know what you think. Again, Attila doesn't run at 60fps all the time. On the campaign map, we're about 40 to 50fps most of the time, but you probably won't notice too much of a difference. But, yeah, do let me know your thoughts. Right, money. We've gone through that, we're going on to the next one. That's taken our coinage. We're going straight on through, that's fine. So that's those two technologies. Then we've got 8 turns for the final bit of tech that we need, which will allow us to get the final building that we need. Because we've already got the other one. How much is it going to be to colonize here? 8,000, that's not too bad. I'm going to repopulate there, recolonize. We could actually get rid of these ships now that we're at peace with the Garamantians, which is good. I was going to take Corallis from them, but we've actually improved. I wonder if we can get trade with them now. No. That's fine, though. I'm not too bothered about that. Is there anyone else we could get trade or stuff with? No. Okay. Right, in that case, it's probably going to be me resettling another province. I mean, I can look at who I'm at war with. So I wouldn't mind a battle, if possible. We're all with the Thrungians, and the Geats will probably attack us somewhere, so we'll maybe have a battle there. But I think I'm just going to have to repopulate, then, in that case. My other forces. Okay, that's fine. I'll happily do that. I can take these guys and go and repopulate down here. Bring this army down, finally, or something. To be fair, we actually have to find an army that's pretty stable. Settlement that's on it. What we got here? We shall see. But that does mean I can get rid of these guys completely from Narbo, which will save a lot of money. Boom. Some of you guys telling me to bring these agents over to keep everyone happy over here. There's a good shout. I will start bringing my dignitaries over. They should just about still be happy. I think I've only got the one. I think the other ones had sort of died now, which is a shame. We'll see if these guys come and attack me again. Not going to be totally against it if they do, because again, I want to test out that battle stuff, so we'll end the turn again. Might be pushing through a few quick turns here. But I would probably say that this Let's Play is going to be wrapped up in the next few parts. And looking at the Divine Triumph vote, the option to continue on neither Saxons or Danes has won. Now, if I combine Saxons and Danes votes together, then there obviously is more demand for a series continuing. But I think both these have got to a state, especially where, you know, we've established an empire, we've gone through deep trials. If I can manage to hit the victory conditions for the Danes, that would be great, especially because we're trying to kill off the Huns right now. We're having a lot of struggle there. After that, for Divine Triumph, really, if the Huns are gone, it is just stomping through AI targets. I don't think that's going to be as much fun, to be honest. I'm not against doing Divine Triumphs, but I think we've already probably had the highlights of both of these campaigns already, or we're going through them right now, especially in the Danes. So I'm certainly a lot happier to end both of them at their military and cultural victories, because I think we've achieved, you know, the best that we can. And dragging them on and past that, it's not really going to be that entertaining. It will pave the way for new Let's Plays. We'll be replacing my first two Let's Plays to end. Will be a Empire Total War Marath Confederacy Let's Play and a Third Age Let's Play. I know other people want me to do Call of Warhammer, Elder Scrolls. Those are all definitely ones that I will consider for future Let's Plays. Probably what will come after the third Let's Play, there'll be a vote as to whether it's a Rome 2 Let's Play with a large overhaul mod on, or whether it's Mountain Blade time for a campaign on that. Faction Destroyed, Antheans. Oh wait, they were my... Yeah, my clients, weren't they? So I've lost... Damn it. He lost the territory now, so I need even more. Great. Right, we're 7 turns on that. Research away. Go, go, go. And then we're done with all the research. We've got to repopulate some lands now, because the Huns keep destroying all my ruddy allies. Which ain't good. I'm not even really bothered about keeping the plague under control or sorting out the food right now. We're just saving all the money to repopulate regions like these guys are going to repopulate here. Colonize. Tarraco instantly happy. Do I need the military presence here? Actually, no, I don't. So I can move them on next turn. We'll repopulate here as well then. Oh, you beauties. Fantastic. Only the same could be said for here. Scoopy. 22 military presence. None of these guys are all in the same one. They're all scattered, dotted around. What about over here? Military presence is 22. Great. The Thrungians are up there. Okay. Unless I can get a military alliance with someone. Who am I super friendly with?
The blessings of the Lord upon you. What then do your noble people desire of us?
Let's start things off with the basics. We'll offer them... Get a non-aggression pact from you if you guys are interested at all. That's all my money. Nope. Okay, what about marriage?
May God bless us both with skillful tongues, that we may speak our parts well.
I'm thinking about it, though. And she's a... Hang on, but they're like Hunnic ones. Hunnic wives. I would offer you money as well, make a marriage, that would really help solidify. Damn it. What about the Western Roman Empire? See, if we get an alliance with them, then we're fine.
Good name, be welcome and speak in friendship. I will give a receptive
ear. Would you like a wife?
To your words.
Nope. In that case, I might just give them... Oh, I can't even offer them a small gift. Try if they want a non-aggression pact. Because if I can get another... Then I don't need to worry about resettling all these regions. No, okay, we'll have to wait and maybe gift them some stuff. Although it's going to be a little while before one of my armies is ready to take another another settlement. So I've got 58 now. 59. Oh, I could take this one actually, finally. It's true. Okay, yeah, we can make it work. End turn again. So this is probably the worst. Let's Play I could have chosen to test 60 FPS out on, because it's mainly all going to be campaign map stuff. But at least we can use this as an audio balancing thing. Ah, no, we've got a battle. Boom, fantastic. Now we can test things out. How do they manage to get all these guys up here? Seriously, it's not cool. Nordic javelin men, yeah, it's good. I have a feeling we won't hold it this time, actually, which is going to cause me even more grief. Nordic horse sword's great. I'm going to have to send an army up here. Bloody geats. I will do my best, though. So now's where the audio balancing really comes into play. Do let me know what it's like. As I said, game probably won't run at 60 FPS all the time, but things should look like they're running a bit smoother and faster. So I hope you enjoy. Okay. It's probably the only time I'll ever see Attila running at this high FPS. It's currently saying I'm running at like between 60 and 80 FPS up here. And of course, I would have the worst map possible to bloody defend on. Ah, seriously? And split like this. Oh, I remember from last time. They've got a pretty good cav. No, have them in the trees here. It's too risky picking them there. Swords. It's where do I choose to hold? My ships are here. I guess we'll put the barricade up here. These guys up there. General, you're going to have to defend here. You guys defend here.
Elite warriors!
Let's defend here. They've got so many swords and cav. I'm not going to be able to hold them all off.
We hunger for blood and battle!
But we'll have to give it a go. Get these guys landing as soon as possible, because then they can help hold here.
Elite warriors! Build this city. We fight now to
defend the city on rock and roll.
Defend these walls with your lives, and if they are breached, and we are forced to fight in the streets, then repel the invaders!
Yeah! Okay, we will. Their general is over here. Oh, he's quite low. An opportunity presents itself. Battle ready. Right up here by the markets.
Surrender! The enemy has been spotted.
In the skirmish, Cav Cam. Oh, they're going to come around here. That's fine. Love these guys ready for them. Elite Degooth Spearmen. Oh, well. Kill them all. Kill all these Nordic warriors. Uh-oh. We're going to send these guys in here. Because otherwise, boss, we're really in the poop. Let's take out the slingers. Horse lords. Get a javelin throw, please. Get a javelin throw. Charge them. Come on. Knock them away. Guys got wrecked here. Just gotta hold here a little bit longer.
They will bleed for us. The men are broken and are fleeing.
Okay, pull these guys over here. Pull these spears over here. These guys are out of ammo, but they can hold. Okay, we've broken those hurlers. I need them gone, though. Quick, form up. Get some throws on these guys. Quick. My only hope is because these guys are so tough, they'll be able to hold out a little bit better. Right, charge these guys. Come on, I think we can turn this one around. More spears over here. If we can get into the back of that general. I want to zoom in as well. Check stuff out. Hold the Degooth spears. Damn, they managed to get in there and stop me. Break one of my units.
Ready for battle? We hunger for blood and battle. Warriors ready. Elite warriors.
Oh, they're broken through here. Spears, come on, catch them. Hold yourself, General. Chop them down. There's just too much cover. We can strike that General. Maybe. Just maybe. Charge to the back of these guys. We'll try and flank around and hit that general. Come on. And form up for a second. Cavalry's probably getting taken out here. Nope. Nice. Charge that general. Come on. Kill that general for me, come on. Frenzy him. Boom. Cav. Slaughter. Come on, we can win this one. We can take him down. I know they're just charging you with new units, so we're going to have to flank round quick. Flank round, men. Charge the back of these Nordic spearmen, then we can pull my Dugarth spears in. No, they're already. That's fine. But I need these guys gone. Charge that general. Come on, I need that general down. Come on, men. Oh no, the Cavs got taken out by the bloody spears that came back. No. Oh yes, enemy general's dead, come on.
Enemy general is fallen. Melee warriors.
Damn, my Cav's gone. Shield wall it. Desperately trying to hold here. I think we're just going to lose it. They raise the settlement. I will be pissed. I will not be a happy bunny. There's not much I can do. Spears versus swords. Oh, they're waving a little bit. Come on. Come on, they're covered by the tower. I can steady them in a minute. Steady, they get some morale boost, come on. See these guys down. I like how they're all in red. Pretty cool. Oh, shunt them forward. My men are just taking too many losses though. Oh no, they're broken. Charge them in the back, charge them in the back, charge them in the back. They completely broke them, come on. Slaughter them through their faces. Finish them. I know we're getting hit by javelins. Oh dear. No, my men are broken. Yes, yes. Ha!
Praise the gods. Your victory is momentary.
Boom, I'm gonna end it there. Christ. That was close. A Pyrrhic victory indeed. I'm definitely going to need to hire a general here and get him recruiting some troops because I can't afford that again. But damn. Those horse swords, 199 kills. Whew. My cavalry actually 387. Javelins 398. Well done. Did good. My biggest mistake there was throwing in that unit of chosen... Elite Nordic Warriors, sorry, and they got wrecked. I will take the replenishment, though, just in case, again, these guys come back. But I'm going to, this time, pop a general in as well. So that we can make up. Whew! So, definitely let me know what the sound was like in that battle, guys. If things need tweaking, if you couldn't quite hear things. Obviously, I don't want to boost it too loud so that it... that my mic input gets kind of suppressed a little bit. So we have to take into account that I don't speak at the same volume level all the time. When I'm excited, I get energized, and when I'm plodding through the campaign map, I talk quieter, lighter. a difficult job, but yeah, really appreciate any feedback you guys can give on this part. I'm glad that we actually managed to have that battle there, because should have shown at least in 60 FPS, 1080 and 720. On YouTube, things should look smoother, snappier, and a bit better, basically, in 30. If you can't notice the difference, then fair enough. I'm kind of just prepping myself to see if this is a viable option. I'll probably be trying to record all my Let's Plays like this. I'll be doing my Denmark one part for today like this as well, and then be awaiting feedback. Oh, seriously? Oh, not cool. Of course, the... Gepids. I will fight this as well, because I don't want to... Oh, I want to take as many of them down as possible, but if the Gepids start raising me as well... Eesh. I probably do... this is probably a lesson about the Thorungians. I need to go and take out that force that's sitting outside my settlement. I can't allow them just to wander around. I shouldn't allow them to do that. I need to either make peace or destroy them next turn when it gets back to mine. Otherwise, I'll be having to wait ages before I can get all my settlements together. The victory conditions. Oh, where's my mouse? Lying around. Okay, they've split like that. Okay, it's this map. That is okay. We'll have that there. And unfortunately, I kind of have to put these guys there because they're the only ones with. Yeah. They've got cavalry coming in, skirmishers, slingers. Their general is over here with some archers. So I'm going to put my cav in the woods here. Spears hold there, and general, I'm going to put you over here just in case they decide to flank me by this tower. I'll have to just make do with what we've got. It fast forward a little bit. If we lose this, then we lose it. It happens, but good. Especially because they left their general behind. If I can snipe him out and those archers, then that is even better. Right, so when these guys come on in... Oh, good. They're trying to send pikes up against my general.
We are outnumbered.
Right, Will. Why is everyone wearing red today?
The enemy is breaking down one of our barricades.
Oh, sorry. I realise what that is. Alliance colouring. That's what it is. I didn't even realise that's what it was. That's why they're all wearing red. Huh, that's really... I've never noticed that before. Wow, fair enough. Pikes do have their pikes, but... not sure they're all getting down. Huh, has anyone else ever done that before, the alliance colouring? That is pretty interesting. Right, let's go take out their general. Huh, I learned something new about Total War all the time. Right. So I'm going to pull my swords back now. We've got the barricade blocking them there. We took down a fair few of them. I might have to bring these guys over here to help out my general. The pikes have taken down their pikes, which is good. I might slam in here with my swords while they're... Oh dear. Cav, no, we don't want to get stuck here. Should put you on skirmish mode, that's my bad. That's it, pull their general away from the fight. There we go, now turn on them and strike him. Whittle him down, then we'll take him out. But yeah, I'm going to pull my swords over here so I can strike and push these guys back. The tower's going to be helping a lot there. We've got a really good position. Spears versus cav, we're fine. Which tower's fallen? Oh, this one up here, that's okay. Well, their general is taking a proper peppering, but now I'm going to, if I'm not careful, because their archers have gone for me, I'm going to quickly charge them before these spears get in there. Try and get a charge on that general. Morale. Smack. Right, they're about to charge him with spears. I've got nothing for it, unfortunately, but to try and pull through out and away, which is not going to end well for my cav. New spacing. Okay, we can try it once more to charge them down. That's okay, that's good. Swords, charge on through. Cav over here. They've managed to push them back here. They're going to try and hit me with their skirmish troops. I love it. They celebrate. No, don't celebrate. Allow my swords to pull through. A little bit. They're still holding. We still under fire. Yeah, I mean, I could go take those archers out, but I'd rather take out their general. I don't think I've got enough stopping power to hit these, but well, I'll sod it. Maybe we do. Go on, risk it. Risk it for a biscuit.
Elite
Nice, we got them here. Quickly charge those slingers, get them down. See these guys come crashing through here. Oh, nice. This guy's going for it. Oh, he's off his horse. Now he's back on his horse. Stop prodding my horse. All my swords back over here. If we are successful against all these archers, then I can go for their general because he's now out in the open. They've sent more spears against me here. I'm struggling a little bit. Glorious battle. Germanic Spearmaster, yeah, they look a lot, I was gonna say, they look a lot nicer than mine. Oh, that's cool. Right, those hunters are nearly gone. Let's just pull away with my cav. These guys will probably come back. Well, maybe not. There's 25 of them, maybe. Let's just form up here. Charge into the back of that general. It's fine, I've got swords, which is going to crash into the spear moss and their general. Oh, cool. Their general's gone down. They shot him in the back. Nice. Cheers, guys. We're just going to sit here while these hurlers try and hurl us. But my towel will take him out. Look at these guys at attack order. We chase you away. Expose your backs and your flanks to my units. Right. Spawn back up here. See the carnage on the floor. I better charge these archers then. I just didn't come back. Okay, we're going to win this one. That's good. I really wasn't expecting to, actually. That's good. Oh, no.
They're trying to hit our flank.
Trying to hit our flank. I get that they've added women into Total War, and this isn't like an anti, you know, equality thing, but that's really not that accurate, is it? I mean, surely, you might have a few, like, camp followers, you know, women fighting in your groups, but surely not on the level that you have in most of these units at this time, surely. Surely it would just be the men that would be primarily going off to war. I can get, like, maybe, okay, like, actually, like this, the garrisons, actually, maybe that makes more sense that you'd have maybe, you know, maybe some women would want to take up the sword or the spear to fight and defend their village. Fair enough. This certainly isn't hating on, you know, women in video games, but I'm not sure it makes a whole lot of sense. But fair enough. Oh, have I lost my cav? They broken. They have. Bless them. Yeah, I mean, what are your thoughts? I mean, I don't mind the units being there, but I mean, if we're looking at, you know, Total War and historical accuracy is, I wouldn't say they're hand in hand. They find a historical setting that they like, and they go from there most of the time. Nice. I mean, like, actually, looking through here, I wouldn't expect any of these guys to have any female units. So maybe, I don't think there are any female units in this unit here. So maybe they've done it in the levies and the militia to try and show that, it would seem. Like, they're in the Nordic levy here. I guess it's, yeah, the Nordic levy. They're levied troops. I don't know. I mentioned this because I saw it on a topic on the forums the other day. I was wondering what your thoughts were on that as well, guys. I know they started this off with the Daughters of Mars DLC for Rome 2, and it's gone from there, really. What do you guys think? Do you mind? Do you care? Would you prefer something more historically accurate units? You know, is there evidence of a lot of women fighting during this period? This is kind of the period just before I studied for university. But looking at army compositions, you know, from that, not really a lot of women. There we go. End the battle. That should have been a slightly better presentation of 60 FPS, because most of the time it was about 50 to 70 in that, because there were far fewer units involved, which is good. Good. We get a close victory, we smash the Gepid forces, so, I mean, they've already gathered loads of mercenaries here. I'm going to have to strike them down or offer them peace. And again, I'm going to take on warriors because it's a garrison, and I want to be able to replenish just in case they decide to attack again. I doubt it. We shall see. Ah, they're trying to hurt my dignitary here. She's bowing. Yes, do the... do the pleasantries before we try and stab each other. Lovely.
The people will turn to the legions, and they will set their swords to your people.
Ah, Hispania, seriously? I'm not going to call data into this. We went through this before, Hispania. We really did. Well, I know what I'm probably going to try and fight. I'll probably fight this in my own time, guys, before the next part. Just try and whittle them down a little bit more. But of course, as per usual, the AI has heard my cunning plans for victory and decided to screw me over just before the end. I think I did mention him, either Huns or Danes, the other day. I was wondering if CA actually programmed in that the AI steps up its aggression level when it knows you're closer to hitting a military or cultural victory, perhaps. Kind of does seem like that. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope the 60 FPS was nice. For the parts of the video that obviously had that higher frame rate, I hope the audio was okay as well. Do let me know in the comments, though. And I will see you all again soon. Until then, don't forget to comment and subscribe. Follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Take pride and join the Legion. Check out my affiliates and sponsors, XMG, Green Man Gaming, and GT Omega Racing. Till next time. Ciao for now.